described in Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Steady now. Easy does it. I'll be down with you in a sec.
We stopped it, Lassie. We stopped it.
Don't let go. Not just yet. Gotta get this old girl tied down nice and tight. All right, you can ease up now, lad. Well, you did a fine job, you and the collie. I want to thank you. And you too, Pooch.
Her name's Lassie.
Oh, Lassie, eh? What's yours?
Timmy Martin.
Well, my name's Jake Hodges, and I want to thank you, Timmy. And you too, Lassie. You know, I might have cracked old Annabelle here into the trees if you hadn't come along and helped me get her down.
Gosh. Why'd you want to land?
Well, I didn't want to, Timmy. I had to. You see, in a balloon, you've got to play it real safe. There's a nasty little squall ended this way. I saw it a few minutes after I got up, and I've been fighting to get Annabelle here down ever since.
How do you get a balloon down anyway?
Well, you see, Timmy, there are two ropes. Now, one is the ripcord. You pull that and you come down, but fast. And the other one controls a valve that lets the gas out real slow and you float down.
Gee.
Now I'll just hitch myself a ride back to the fairgrounds, grab me balloon gear, and I'll be back here before the storm hits.
My dad has to go into town. He'll be glad to drop you by the fairgrounds.
Well, I called that real neighborly of you. You've been a great help. And you'll find Jake's not one to forget a favor. Come on, lad. Well, thanks again, lad.
That's okay.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do. When you come to the fair, I'm going to give you a free-for-nothing ride. You and Lassie, both of you. How's that? Would you like that, eh?
Would I? Could we, Jack?
Well, I guess it's all right for you. But I'm not so sure about Lassie.
She'd like it, too. Wouldn't you, girl?
Looks as if Lassie wouldn't fancy a ride.
I know she would.
Well, we'll see. Toodaloo, Timmy.
Toodaloo. Come here. What's the matter? You chicken or something? Keep an eye on that balloon.
Timmy's quite a fan of yours. We've been watching you fly over here almost every day.
Oh, I'm honored. And lucky. You know, without his help, it might have taken me a lot longer to get Annabelle down.
I'm curious. How will you deflate the balloon?
Well, we don't. We take the basket off, and then we bed the balloon down with sandbags. And then tomorrow, when the wind... Stop the truck!
What is it?
I think I saw Annabelle.
I don't see anything. I could have sworn it was my balloon. What do you think we should do?
Better hot foot it to where I left her.
luck. Annabelle must have worked herself loose. Hello? How do you suppose that happened?
What?
This sledge. I distinctly remember putting it back in the basket.
Was anybody near the balloon when you left it?
No. Timmy and Lassie helped me to bring it down.
Maybe Timmy knows something about it.
Come on, let's go ask him.
Timmy in there?
No. He went off somewhere with Lassie just after you left.
Blimey, there's Annabelle. Someone's turned on the bloomin' music.
You mean someone's in there?
Seems like it.
Timmy?
Timmy!
Jenny, get me the sheriff's office. Quickly, please.
What is it, Paul?
Well, we're not sure yet. Look, Sheriff, this is Paul Martin. You know that balloon that was used to advertise the county fair? Well, it broke loose and... There's a strong possibility that Timmy and Lassie are in it.
What do you mean? Well, they couldn't be.
Ruth, dear, now please, it's going to be... Sorry, Sheriff. What was that? Yes. Yes, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Up in that balloon.
Ruth. We don't know that they are. Only that he and Lassie were the only ones who knew where the balloon was. And that somebody's up in that balloon now.
Well, you've got to do something.
The sheriff knows what to do, and he promised to call back in a little while. Well, now, in the meantime, the balloon is... Well, maybe...
Terrified.
We're going higher all the time.
Yes? Reassure.
I see. Yes. All right. Thank you. Now listen, dear. It may take a little time to locate the balloon because of the fog that set in, but well, the forest rangers are on the lookout, and Civil Air Patrol will send out search planes and helicopters. Ruth, we've got to have a little faith. Why don't you start the supper, dear? They may be home by then, and they'll be plenty hungry. I can see someone, or at least talk to somebody who can give us some information.
Timmy Martin, the young boy who, with his pet dog, is adrift in a runaway balloon.
Use North Runway 2 for takeoff.
Repeat. F-937, use North Runway 2 for takeoff.
Uh-huh. Now we figure it this way. Prevailing winds are north by northwest.
So, allowing for slight variations in wind velocity, the balloon should be traveling in a northerly direction at a rate of approximately 30 miles an hour. Now, I'd suggest you Rangers cover the Mitchell County area. Right. Four of our planes are ready now.
F-937.
Okay for takeoff. Please report on weather conditions over Granite Peak.
F-937 to tower. There's nothing yet. I'm heading south over Falmouth River.
C-664, return to base, over and out.
This is F-937. No sign of the balloon over Mitchell County. Running out of fuel and we'll put down at Danfield Airport. Over and out.
R-386, calling CAP. R-386. No luck on this leg. Waiting further instructions. Over.
R-386, return by way of South Fork River. Pete ran out of fuel in that area. Over.
Gotcha. Heading for South Fork right now. Burn out.
I can't understand it. If that balloon had come down, one of our planes should have spotted it by now.
Do you think there's a chance it might still be up in the air?
Yes. Yes, could be. With strong prevailing winds due north, it could have blown across the Canadian border.
Good Lord.
Give me Civil Aviation Board headquarters in Canada, please.
Made the gas come out real slow.
Thank you.
down. Almost.
Yes, Cully. No. No, there's nothing you can do. Well, now that the weather's clear, the Civil Air Patrol is sure they'll be found soon. Yes. Yes, I will. Oh, I'll let you know right away. All right. Goodbye.
Jump! You all right, girl? Touch my shirt.
Thank you.
fairies.
Try them, Lassie. They're full of juice. Now quench your thirst.
American calculations are correct. The balloon might possibly be in this region here. George, call Mountie headquarters and alert them. Ned, you notify the Rangers to keep a sharp lookout. Let's get all our planes in the air over this area. This is Erickson. Get me the radio network office. I want to talk to the news editor.
Get this bone made, girl. I'll have you some food in no time.
That the Indians used to heat the points of their arrows to harden them.
Lassie!
He's got to be all right. Easy, girl. You just lie quiet. At least we have something to eat. As soon as I build a fire. About little things.
Thank you. is Tompkins reporting in. I've sighted the balloon.
It's hanging in tall pines, approximately 12 miles from the south branch of Wilderness River and about
20 miles from Loon Lake. Couldn't see any sign of boy or dog. Over.
Circle and no landmarks. Then report back. Over and out. Edna, get me the American CAP headquarters. You know, the one that contacted us.
No, there's no sign of the boy or dog yet, but the Canadian authorities are launching an all-out search in that area. Incidentally, I'm sure the parents would appreciate all the cooperation they can get from you newspaper folks and everybody else. Sure. So long.
Well, take it easy, darling. At least they've pinpointed the area where they came down. Now listen carefully. Captain Stanley has arranged to fly us up there this afternoon. You pack a bag, and I'll be home in about an hour to pick you up. Okay?
All right, dear. All right. Please, God, let him be all right.
Now, the river will take you within 12 miles, more or less, of where the balloon was spotted. I believe you're going to have to go in from here.
Ranger Henty reporting, sir.
Hello, Henty. This is Sprague and McDonald. You'll be going with them.
Hello.
How do you do?
We're just trying to figure out the best route to this spot where the balloon went down.
Couldn't have picked a worse place. There isn't a road within 20 miles.
That's right. I think you better go to this point by truck and then take the river to here. And the rest of the way, gentlemen, will be on foot.
God help the wee lad if he's wandered any distance from that balloon.
Here, Matt. Take this map with you. Thank you, sir.
Well, gentlemen, shall we get going?
Not so fast, Carl.
Better get going. John Stanley said that plane was going to leave at 3 o'clock.
I'm all ready. I just thought I'd take Timmy's sweater with us. You know, the one that Cully gave him last Christmas? It must be awfully cold up in those Canadian woods, and I wouldn't want him catching cold.
Oh, I'm sure we'll be able to find a sweater for him up there.
Yes, I guess so. What do you really think?
I think you're the bravest woman in all the world.
I mean, do you think they'll find him?
I'm sure they will.
I keep thanking God that Lassie's with him.
Well, if anyone can take care of him, Lassie can.
You want to call Cully and ask him to take care of the farm while we're away?
I already have. I think maybe it'd be a good idea to take this sweater along after all.
Thank you.
Lassie, Dad once told me that if you follow a river far enough, you will eventually come to people. Yeah, girl. We'll build a raft. Come on.
Right here. The balloon is about 12 miles due west.
Okay, let's go.
Laughing. He's let the dog down with a sling and used the rope for himself. He's a smart kid, all right. Looks like they took out toward the river.
We better get going.
And pray we're not too late. He's dragged some logs through here.
He's smart, all right. He's built himself a raft.
Well, that means he's gone downriver.
Too bad he didn't stay here.
What do you think we ought to do?
Well, I'll go back and get the canoe. You stay here and set up a base camp.
Will do.
Help me out with this pack.
And we'll keep in touch with headquarters on the short wave.
This is Randy Collins coming to you once again by remote control from the Mountie headquarters at Loon Lake. The plight of a small boy and his faithful collie dog, lost somewhere in the vast Canadian wilderness, is tugging at the heartstrings of the entire continent, ladies and gentlemen.
Stand by, ladies and gentlemen. I think Mr. and Mrs. Martin are here now.
Oh, Mrs. Martin, will you join your husband in the searching party?
Oh, no.
When will you leave, Mr. Martin?
Well, as soon as transportation's available. If you'll excuse us now, Sergeant Major Hardwick's waiting to talk to us.
But Mrs. Martin, would you care to make a statement to the other mothers and fathers who might be listening in?
Well, yes, but only just to express appreciation for the many prayers and messages of sympathy. Oh, yes, and to say thank you to the Canadian authorities for their cooperation.
Thank you. That was Mrs. Paul Martin, thanking all the people of the expressed
Mr. Martin?
This is my wife.
How do you do, Mrs. Martin? Won't you please have a seat?
Thank you.
Mr. Martin, we've finally located a helicopter for you. It should be here sometime this afternoon.
Have you heard any more about the progress of the search, I mean?
We'll soon be in direct contact with our search party by short wave from their camp.
You will let me know, won't you, the minute you hear anything?
Immediately, Mrs. Martin. Two of my best men have been assigned to the case. They know the area well, and they know how to cover it. We have accommodations for you at the hotel across the square.
Thank you.
I'll call you as soon as the helicopter arrives.
I won't try to thank you.
No doubt you've heard of the Mountie tradition, that he always gets his man. I believe in this instance we can broaden that to include his small boy and his lost dog.
We've been in touch with headquarters on the short wave. The lad's parents are there, and his father's been flown down here by copter. Should be here later today or tonight.
Well, Mac and I'll follow the river down as far as the falls.
Well, I hope we've got some news for his father when he gets here.
If we haven't found the boy by the time we reach the falls, any news we could give him would be bad.
We'll keep in touch by walkie-talkie.
Right.
Thank you.
dog Lassie is?
Thank you. Lassie.
Chinook Pete's place.
Chinook Pete?
Yeah, you know, the Indian. The deaf mute whose wife and child died last year during the epidemic.
Let's take a look around inside. Could have been here.
There's nothing to show that he was. Hey, where'd Lassie go?
Lassie! 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 Come here, Lassie!
She's out there somewhere.
Down a river. We got separated. I don't know where she is. She might be drowned. I almost got drowned myself.
Well, you're safe now, Timmy. Everything's all right.
Dad, we just gotta find Lassie.
First, we've gotta get you back to your mother. She's worried half to death.
What about Lassie?
Lassie can take care of herself, Timmy. We'll find her. We'll find her.
We can put down at the ranger camp by the river.
and probably reach Mrs. Martin by short way from there. Maybe they have some news about the boy's dog.
Could we, Dad? We can talk to Mom that much sooner.
Yeah, sure, Timmy. Sure. Come on.
I know you are, dear. I just wanted to hear your voice.
It sounds good to hear your voice, too. I thought I might never hear it again.
Timmy, your dad didn't say anything about Lassie. Have they found her?
No, Mom, they haven't.
Base camp. Hello, this is McDonald calling base camp. Over.
This is McDonald calling base camp. Do you read me?
Henty here.
Henty, report this to headquarters. That we've got the dog and she's alive. Over.
No, never mind. Hold on. Timmy! Timmy! They found Lassie!
Lassie! Lassie!
They've got the boy.
Thank you.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.